So we're here backstage on day three of Isle of Wight Festival, and now we're joined by a man who should look terrible, but he looks good. I don't know what's going on here.
I'm very happy. Very happy.
John Giddings, creator of the Isle of Wight Festival, curator, man about sight, I suppose you'd call you as well. How are you feeling right now, Si?
I'm great. I just walked halfway up the site, and people are so happy after last night with Blur and Pharrell. It was extraordinary. That's one of our best Saturday nights ever.
Definitely.
They were incredible.
Yes.
Yeah, and you got the weather as well on the Saturday. Goodness me.
Well, people keep saying my nose is so burned. So it must have been some good weather sometime.
I mean, Blur and Fleetwood Mac have both been on the wish list for some time, haven't they?
Yeah, I've wanted both acts for at least 5 years, and for them to come together at the same time is extraordinary. I can't believe it. I walked up on stage and saw one of the flight cases with Fleetwood Mac written on it. I nearly cried. It was like, oh my God, they're coming. They're
especially
here.
Especially after this week. I mean, it's been touch and go, is it?
Well, they cancelled Birmingham, then I reckon they cancelled Manchester to save this gig, because you can reschedule Birmingham, you can reschedule Manchester. If they'd played Manchester, they probably wouldn't have got better in time. So, you know, I think it's going to be incredible. They restart the tour tonight. Really looking forward to it.
And I guess, you know, while we're on sort of it being a bit touch and go, I know Damon Albarn wasn't feeling brilliant yesterday, was he?
But oh,
he
God, at 10 o'clock yesterday morning, the gig was cancelled.
Really?
Oh, yeah, I didn't tell anybody. Then at lunchtime, instead of doing an hour and 50 minutes, it was going to be an hour and 30 minutes. Then at 4 o'clock, it was an hour and 40 minutes. 5 o'clock was an hour and 45. And I'd put everybody back to accommodate the shorter time.
Right.
So by the time an hour before they went on, they wanted to do an hour and 50 minutes again. They finished at 1 minute to 12. Didn't break the curfew, incredible.
Yes, well, we had the set list and we were sort of advised that some of the songs towards the end might go. I think like
the ones where you really had to belt out the
high notes. But he did them all.
He did the lot. He was really enjoying himself, wasn't he? He loved it.
Yeah.
You could see him really glancing back at his band, sort of going, really enjoying this. And we just found out that we knew of one person going down on one knee and professing their undying love for someone. Apparently, you just told us about another one as well during the
because we had to get some people up for the James flash mob, and at the end, one guy went down on his knee and proposed to his girlfriend in front of 50,000 people. She didn't have much of a choice, really, did she?
No, I'll
think about it and get back to you.
Yeah, I'm a little bit annoyed that you got Sarah up on a stage, because not that I wouldn't want to be up there, but she won't show up about it.
I was looking for people. I said, do you like James? She said, yeah. I said, do you want to go on stage? She said, yeah. I couldn't stop her then. She danced very well.
Yeah, oh, thank you.
Wait till you see it on television.
I cannot wait. I'm counting the seconds.
Oh, it's going to be sober one up there. Pharrell was excellent last night. I have to say, I mean, just the crowd were absolutely loving him. I mean, you've toured with him. Was he sort of the easiest booking of this weekend for you?
Well, he's just such an incredible person. And, you know, everybody's saying to me today how good he was last night, and I know how good he is, so I'm surprised by them being surprised he was that good, if you see what I mean. Okay. And he was so kind to that kid with cerebral palsy, and that girl that got up and
I mean, now, was that planned?
Is this program for children?
That performance blooming wasn't, goodness me.
There was
boggling, there was daggering, there was all kinds of things going on.
That's
going
to go viral, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Obviously, you know, we sort of hear all the on-stage stuff, but I was reading an interview with the Good Samaritans recently, and talking about some of the backstage stories that obviously you're well aware of. Paul McCartney ordering false nails?
Well, I couldn't work it out. I was standing in the middle of the field on Sunday morning, and I thought they must be really bored. They called me up and they said, can you get someone to do acrylic nails? And I thought, what's acrylic nails? I never even heard of it. So I went to the nail and hair place and talked to a woman. I said, what are acrylic nails? She said, well, we do them, we don't have the kit. So I was standing there thinking, what do I do now? And I looked in the yellow pages, and there was a woman in Cowes who did it, who came over. It was absolutely wonderful. And he had dinner with her. I thought it was for backing singers or something. It was for his own nails, because he strengthens them to play the acoustic guitar. I just thought they wanted to wind me up. It's like saying, can you get me an elephant on the Isle of Wight? You know,
can you get me
waste
a long stand,
time
and pen, stuff like that. So where do you start with next year's festival? Obviously, you must have a long list that's going to get a little
started.
Shorter. You've already started.
Yeah, as soon as you finish booking this one, you start obsessing about the next one. It doesn't start on Monday, it's already started.
Goodness me. Anybody you really want? Anybody you've got on the
wish
list?
Lots of people I want. I want Oasis when they reform. I want the Foo Fighters to come back. Best of luck with his leg, by the way.
Yeah, goodness me.
Pharrell has replaced him at Pinkpop tonight in Holland, because he can't do it. who's cancelled it. And Roger Waters, I'd really like if he does the hits okay. of Pink Floyd. I think that would be good. Mm. Depeche Mode, we've never had. Coldplay could come back. Yeah. The list is endless, isn't it? Yeah. Who would you like to see?
I think Foo Fighters would be a good show. Yeah. I grew up with that band.
I love
the Foo Fighters for a very long time.
You're going to go some to top this year for me, John. This is my dream life.
I know. I can see. Look at your face. Blur, the Charlatans. The funniest bit was on Thursday night, actually, the campers night, because I put on the tribute Oasis band. I swear to God, this woman walked in and said, "How did you get Oasis to open the show?" I said, "Look at the backdrop. It says no Oasis." But he was so in character, he threatened to come back and hit Damon the next day.
Brilliant. Or hit the Damon from the Blur tribute band, maybe. That would have been good. Yeah. That would have been good. Sir, thank you for joining us this afternoon.
Thanks very much for having me. I appreciate it. I'll see you later.
Go
cheers.
Go do some firefighting.